Pleasant good evening to you, Blue Hens fans, and welcome inside the Bob Carpenter Center in Newark, Delaware, as the Delaware Blue Hens, 11-12 on the season, 4-6 in conference play, welcome in their rivals in the Towson Tigers, 15-8 on the season, 5-5 in CAA play. My name is Corey Nido, filling in for the voice of the Blue Hens, Scott Klatskin, alongside Bill Harmon. Let's get you tonight's starting lineups for this CAA matchup, beginning with the visiting Tigers of Towson. At guard, it's a 6'3" senior, Brian Starr. Mike Morcell stands 6'5", a guard and senior. Forward is Eddie Keith the second. He stands 6'5" and a senior. Sophomore guard and scoring machine, Zane Martin, is the point guard. And forward, Alex Thomas, a junior, stands 6'9". That's your starting five for Towson. For the Blue Hens, it will be a freshman guard, Ryan Allen, averaging 14.2 points per game. One of the leading scorers that his Blue Hens team will rely on moving forward. Anthony Mosley, a senior guard, 6'1", will also join him. Darian Bryan, a junior, 6'4", he will play guard as well. Eric Carter will be down low, a junior forward. He stands at 6'9", averaging 10.2 points a game. And Kyrie Walker, number 11, a freshman forward at 6'5", rounds out the starting five for the Delaware Blue Hens. Your starting lineups presented by your local Chevy dealer. Visit chevydealer.com. And Bill, we talked about the atmosphere here tonight in the Bob Carpenter Center. It's getting pretty loud for this rivalry game.
Well, it's really good to see some of the students back, Corey, and welcome again to the show. It's great to have you with us, sitting in for Scotty. Towson is going to be a very difficult opponent tonight. They've been playing offensively at a very high level. We've already chronicled their defensive prowess. They're really tough. They put a lot of ball pressure on you. They bump every cutter. They're an excellent defensive rebounding team that can initiate some fast breaks with that tough guy rebounding. They've got an excellent score in Zane Martin. Anthony Mosley will draw the assignment there, and that'll be a wonderful matchup to watch. And then a really neat one will be Darian Bryant against the senior veteran Mike Morcell. They were teammates in high school, but they've known each other since they were 7 years old. So a really neat rivalry there that we'll get a chance to talk about.
Certainly is. The jerseys for tonight, Delaware wearing their home white jerseys with Delaware scripted across the chest, outlined in gold. Blue shoulder tops, white shorts with the Blue Hen on the shorts. And for Towson, they're wearing their road black jerseys with gold, white, and black stripes, yellow stripes around the shoulders, white numerals, and golden trim. And we had a late change to the Towson lineup. It will be Gorham starting for Towson. At the center of the court, it is Carter, Eric Carter, and Alex Thomas for the tip-off as we're just moments away for the CAA contest. Ball is up, and it goes in favor of Delaware. Mosley, the point guard, dribbles up the court, waiting for his offense to set. Passes it over to Darian Bryant on the far right wing. Gives it down low. Bounce pass over, it kicked out of the way. Bryant gets the ball back in his hands. 11 on the shot clock. Carter looking for some help. Now gives it to Mosley, top of the key. 6 on the shot clock. Need a shot soon. Bryant looking up. 3-2, shot is off and it hits the rim and rebounded by Towson.
A good hard hedge up top, taking Delaware out of their offensive rhythm. The switch to Gorham is for 2 extra inches inside to battle Sky Johnson and Eric Carter.
Deep three missed by Zane Martin, who has scored 30 points in multiple games this year for Towson. Delaware's basketball ticking inside the first minute of competition. No score yet between the two teams. Allen swings out to Bryant. Good ball movement around the perimeter. Bryant gets it top of the key, now back to Allen, who dribbles, drives, pulls up. High arcing shot, rims in and out of the tin, and rebounded by Justin Gorham.
Gorham already showing his impetus into the game with that tough guy rebound inside, and a nice matchup down on the baseline with Ryan Allen versus the other lefty, Zane Martin.
Gorham with the fadeaway jumper, no good. Carter skying high for the rebound.
Towson loves to run a lot of half-court sets. We'll see them out of a 1-4 elbow and a lot of horns, which is two high post screeners.
Allen running the point position, dribbles with his left, gives it to the tall man Carter on the right wing. Chest pass over to Mosley. And now the ball back in Allen's hand. 9 on the shot clock. Delaware very methodical offensively. Still no score yet. 3 on the shot clock, 2. Mosley heaves it up top of the key and he misses. Shot clock violation, and it will be Towson basketball. So far, Bill, first two possessions, it's been tough sledding for the offense.
Well, rhythmically, Towson takes you out of a lot of things. As I mentioned, they're very good about getting in the passing lanes. Good ball pressure, doing a nice job side fronting, almost three-quarter front inside to take away Sky Johnson and Eric Carter. A nice defensive game plan early on.
Nice feed down low to Mike Morcell, and Towson scores first. It's 2-0.
Morcell very good at moving without the ball, a la Bill Bradley. Look for him to work along the baseline as well as out front.
Bryant with the ball, dribbles in between his legs, kicks it out to Allen, who now treks over near top of the key. Mosley loses the handle on the ball, got bumped by Thomas. 9 on the shot clock again. Carter trying to work against Thomas, backing him down, and it will be an offensive foul on Eric Carter. It will be his first personal and team's first.
Alex Thomas was giving up absolutely no ground as Eric Carter tried to work to his left shoulder, dribbling with his right hand. At that point, what he should do is pivot to the baseline and show a fake and may be able to elevate Thomas, but going inside created the offensive foul.
Blue Hens trail 2-0, 17-18 remaining on the clock. Jumper is no good by Thomas. Rolled around the rim, but Delaware able to corral the board.
Delaware allowing Thomas to shoot that wide open 15-footer. That's part of the game plan.
Carter backs him down again and once more called for an offensive foul, and he has 2 quick fouls here in the first half.
The scouting report on Eric Carter on the left side of the low block is to take away his left shoulder. Thomas adhering to that. Pat Scarry, a really good defensive coach from Medford, Mass, working his team really hard over there on the sideline, very engaged.
So that will take Carter out of the game for now. Here comes Jacob Cushing, a 6'8" sophomore in for the Blue Hens. Towson moving right to left on your dial. Up 2-0 here in the early stages of the first half. Good ball movement. Morcell with the ball. Gives it back and forth. Now has it on the far right wing. Now it's Gorham trying to back down Cushing. Spins and misses. Gets his own rebound. Tries to go up against. Rotates once more. Floats it in for the bucket. And the Towson Tigers lead 4-0.
Gorham, very athletic, a very quick jumper, 6'7", sophomore, 230. He's got a man-sized body. Jacob Cushing on the challenge has got to be sure he puts his body on Gorham and not allow him to get that second chance opportunity, which he took advantage of.
Blue Hens looking for their first basket. Mosley gets fouled and the one. Check that. It's Allen. Deep three, heaves it up, gets contact made, and now has a chance to tie this game up at 4.
Well, Zane Martin was slow coming off the screen. He trailed it. Ryan Allen, if anything he is a quick shooter. He can get himself squared up. He's got a wonderful high release and did a really nice job there of acting that one out as Zane Martin clipped his hip as he went to contest.
Allen completes the 4-point play, and just like that, it's all knotted, 4 apiece with 16:23 remaining in the first half.
One of the rules is when you close a shooter out, you never want to run by them, run to them, so you do not foul the man on the way up.
Martin runs the point guard position for Towson. He has been incredible this year. Ball now into the far corner. Down low, now kicks it back out. Good ball movement by the Tigers this possession. Martin being guarded by Mosley. Deep three taken by Towson, and it's missed by Morcell. Rebounded by Sky Johnson.
Delaware switched from their man-to-man to a 2-3 zone. That confused Towson. They did not get into their offense until too late. Morcell forced to take a long-range shot. Sky Johnson doing a great job of defending the glass.
Cushing with the ball, top of the key. Bryant now feeds it down to Johnson, who's too hard off the glass, rebounded by Zane Martin, and here come the Tigers.
Well, he was very smart in turning to his right shoulder with his left hand. Just couldn't get stabilized down there. Thomas bumped him enough just to throw him off the shot.
Martin tried to dribble drive in, a lot of traffic. Ball gets loose. Towson recovers. 14 on the shot clock. Martin now signaling a play, dribbling with his right hand, now left.
Delaware still staying in this 2-3 zone. They've got to locate Martin and locate Morcell.
4 on the shot clock. Martin looking to heave it up. He does. It hits the rim. It's short. Rebounded by Mosley. And here come the Hens trying to push it. Allen moving left to right, Cushing in the far right corner, thought about a three, now gives it to Allen, who pulls the trigger and finds the bottom of the net, and the Blue Hens have their first lead. It's 7-4.
Delaware taking advantage of transition mismatch. Thomas was extended on Ryan Allen, but unfortunately not far enough from Towson's perspective. He's got to make Ryan Allen be a dribbler there, allowed him to rise up into a shot.
Star bounce, passes it to Gorham with the nice finger roll floater, finds the bottom of the net.
Good job by Towson with the bounce pass going inside of the post as Gorham moving right to left with a turnaround shot from about 8 feet.
7-6, Blue Hens lead, 14-24 and counting here in the first half. Mosley with the ball, gives it to Bryant in the far right corner. Steps twice, misses, it looked like it got blocked actually, and here comes the Tigers with Marcel leading the charge. He goes up, acrobatic lay-in, misses, and it's an offensive foul, and it will be Delaware's basketball.
Well, that was a great job by Delaware getting back on defense and then blocking out after the wild shot was taken by Marcel. Getting a body on these transition rebounds is really important.
We'll be right back with more media timeout here. Delaware leads 7-6, 14-11 remaining in the first half. You're listening to Blue Hens Radio on 94.7 WDSD.
The official bird of Delaware isn't red. It's not green or purple. It's blue. Coincidence? We think not. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware. This blue hen does not need to see a podiatrist. But if he did, waiting for a referral might get his feathers in a bunch. And he wouldn't like that one bit. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware.
Hi guys, it's great to be here.
In the desert.
At the mall.
On the mountain.
At school.
At the beach.
In the Big Easy.
Yeah.
Today I want to show you guys the next gen Chevy Equinox. What do you think?
That's pretty.
Pretty sexy.
It's all wheel drive, look at that.
It looks aggressive.
But not overbearing.
It's not too big, not too small.
Looks like it could go off-roading.
But at the same time, it looks like a car you could take to a nice event.
You can dress it up or dress it down.
Seems like the perfect car for anybody.
I would take it anywhere.
I want one.
I love it.
She's a bad mamma jamma.
Chevy stepped their game up.
Carpenter Center, Delaware leads 7-6, 14-11 here in the first half. Chevrolet of Dover is now offering a free lifetime powertrain warranty on any vehicle purchased 6 years and newer with up to 84,000 miles. Find new roads, visit ChevroletofDover.com. Well, Bill, coming out of this break, looking at the stats, it's not pretty offensively. Towson shooting just 3-for-10 from the floor while Delaware 2-for-7. What does each offense need to do to try and find some rhythm?
Well, I think they've got to find a way to reverse the ball more often and more quickly. If you stay stagnant, the defense can engulf you, and that's what Towson loves to do. But one thing Delaware has done with the 2-3 zone is done a nice job of identifying where Zane Martin is. He's 0-for-2 from the three, and he's been shooting it almost at 40%, and we'll see somewhere around 45% of his attempts from the outside are going to be from the three-point line.
Blue Hens will get the ball moving left to right on the dial. They inbound it. Kyrie Walker in the game for the Blue Hens. A little pressure by Towson. Delaware gets it over midcourt. Going all the way, Mosley trying. Gets blocked, but Sky Johnson is there with the rebound and putback. And the Blue Hens lead 9-6.
Sky Johnson's physicality has been a big factor in his improvement. He's been willing to put his body on opponents. He does a good job of positioning and anticipating where the miss is going.
Keith has the ball, first time we've seen him. He's getting double teamed right now. Now it's backed off Allen on him. Ball goes back to the perimeter. 9 on the shot clock. Good defense by the Blue Hens. Miscommunication, and it's an easy turnover, and here comes Cushing and the Blue Hens. Cushing dribbles with his life, goes up the glass, can't make it fall. Mosley gets the rebound, stutter steps, floats it in, and finds the bottom of the net for another bucket for the Blue Hens.
I love the concept of both Cushing and Mosley attacking the basket. It may result in a few block shots, but we may be able to get to the foul line more often. Jacob Cushing, a very smart adjustment to his game, not settling for the long range shot, trying to attack via the dribble.
First bucket made by Mosley. Blue Hens up by 5 with 12:57 and counting in the first half. Foul is called.
This zone, Corey, has really confused Towson. They haven't gotten into their set early enough, and they do like to run some sets against zone. A lot of teams will dribble attack through the gaps or try to skip the ball. Towson more willing to set some upper level screens and try to then go through the middle or attack along the baseline as Zane Martin did. A tough call there against Kyrie Walker, who was doing a good job of harassing Martin on that left baseline.
Walker's first personal, team's third for Delaware. 11-6, Blue Hens lead it. As Towson has the ball moving right to left, Brian Starr working out of the point guard position. Top of the perimeter, swings it out over to Jordan McNeil. First time we've seen him tonight. Gorham needing help by the charity stripe, kicks it back out to McNeil, and it's a shot clock violation. And it will be Delaware basketball. Great defense by the Blue Hens.
Well, the zone has extended to accommodate Zane Martin, and then that left McNeil with nothing to do but shoot from the top of the key, and Ryan Allen got a piece of it. It was a shot clock violation before, but our zone is much more active than it's been recently, Corey. Part of that is we've been playing it more often, so we're getting a better feel for the gaps and bumping players along.
Blue Hens still up by five. As they move left to right, it's Allen with the basketball, pulls up for three, and it's good. Ryan Allen feeling it early tonight.
Ryan Allen, a rhythmic shooter who loves the elbow extended long range shot, does a great job with shot preparation and rises above opponents with a terrific vertical leap.
Towson tries to answer, but Gorham's floater no good. Blue Hens with the rebound, now Allen pushing the pace. Mosley with it, gets fouled, and he will go to the line.
Anthony Mosley trying to take advantage of Towson not getting back as quickly in transition as they need to. A good job attacking the middle of that defense.
We'll be right back in our media timeout. Delaware leads at 14-6. You're listening to Blue Hens Game Day on 94.7 WDSD. And Bill, it's really Delaware's pace of play that's really helped them get out in front early on.
I love the usage of the shot clock. We've let it run down. We've taken shots late in it, other than that one jumper by Ryan Allen. We probed a little bit, but it's been our defense. Towson looks very confused against our 2-3. We've extended out. We've challenged shooters. And most importantly, done a really good job inside against an excellent offensive rebounding team. Only one offensive rebound so far. That was Gorham on his earlier miss, but the 2-3 zone right now is something I'm sure Pat Scarry is working hard on.
Towson has been without a basket in the last 2 minutes and 41 seconds, so a great job by the Blue Hens, as Bill mentioned. Play resumes with 11:55 remaining in the first half. Blue Hens have the ball, and it is Darian Bryant on top of the key, gives it out to Allen, who has three trays already, going for four. A little too hard off the side of the left rim, rebounded by Towson. And here comes Mike Morsell and company. Towson gets the foul. Eddie Keith was driving to the hoop, and it will be against Jacob Cushing. Oh, check that, Sky Johnson on the foul.
Keith not starting tonight as Gorman stepped into the role to give them a little bit more height. But Keith is a wily veteran, loves to put the ball on the floor and attack the basket.
14 fouls for Delaware. That was Johnson's first. Morsell on the near left corner of the three-point line where we're at on the court. Here's a three taken by Jordan McNeil, it's short, rebounded by Delaware.
And we're doing this without Eric Carter, who's out with two early offensive fouls that Thomas did a great job of drawing. So Sky Johnson and others are going to have to do a great job of rebounding.
Ryan Allen trying to create separation, too short on his jumper. Here comes Towson right to left. Nice bounce pass into Dennis Tunstall, but it's rejected. And here come the Blue Hens, another good defensive stand.
Good job by Jacob Cushing and Sky Johnson, both challenging that shot by Dennis Tunstall, who's got to do a better job of utilizing a shot fake.
Blue Hens lead it 14-6 here in the first half, 10:46 ticking off the clock. Johnson down low, loses the handle of the basketball, and it goes out of bounds, and it will be Tigers basketball.
A nice pass as Darian Bryant drove in the lane left to right, a little over-the-shoulder drop-off pass to Sky Johnson. He got bumped and unfortunately wasn't able to secure the ball. It goes out, but I like the action and the activity by Darian Bryant, who needs to drive the ball more often against this man-to-man of Towson's.
Big man Alex Thomas checking back in for Towson, 6'9" junior. Has played over 15 minutes in only two CAA games this year. Bounce pass to Keith down low, another feed to Martin, who missed with the reverse lay-in. Martin's been quiet so far tonight, and that's certainly a recipe for Delaware if they want to win tonight.
Well, the zone has bothered Martin, also the length of Delaware when they're playing a man-to-man with Darian Bryant covering him, or Anthony Mosley's done a nice job of working the baseline against him.
Bryant's pass gets tipped by Johnson and then intercepted by Towson's Eddie Keith. Keith dribbles with his left, now swings it out. Martin wide open tray, and it's off the mark. Walker and Thomas were going after the rebound, and it looked like it was last touched by Thomas of Towson, so Delaware will get the basketball.
Delaware very fortunate there. I'm not sure the configuration of that zone. It looked like a 1-4. That's why Zane Martin was wide open here on the left at the top of the key for a wide open three. Towson will show some different pressures, especially when they're behind. This is a 1-2-2 three-quarter court, just a semi-harassment press, just to slow Delaware down and not allow them to get into rhythm offensively.
Cushing gives the ball to Carter, who almost lost the handle, regathers it. Now swings out to Cushing, top of the key for three. Rims off the right side of the bucket, rebounded by Towson. Martin dribbling through traffic, he's off the mark, rebounded by Towson. Eddie Keith pulls up for three, he's too hard, and there's Cushing for Delaware with another board.
Towson settling for some questionable shots as well. Delaware needs to work the ball back inside or drive it with splitting kicks.
Ryan Allen gives it to Bryant, who can't finish. Carter tries to go for the tip-in, and he is fouled on the shot. But good ball movement there on that possession.
Well, Delaware has done a nice job of sharing it for the most part. I love it when Ryan Allen, who's known as a long-range shooter, either uses a shot fake or uses a pump fake to go by. He splits into the middle and delivers a terrific pass to Darian Bryant, who then attacked the run out on him along the baseline, and that created the activity. When you can reverse the ball against a man-to-man defense, it really makes it hard for their slides and their helps to occur as quickly and as angular as possible.
Blue Hens inbound the ball. They're up 14-6, looking to add to their lead. They have been keeping Towson off the board for over 5 minutes. Carter with the spin-around floater finds the bottom of the mesh.
Terrific adjustment there by Eric Carter, not lowering his left side of his body and the shoulder against Thomas as he did two times earlier in the game to draw the offensive fouls, and finishing with that left shoulder jump hook.
Deep corner three, good by Mike Morcell. Morcell has chucked 102 threes coming into tonight's game. He likes to pull it up from beyond the arc, connects, and it's a 16-9 lead for Delaware. Carter with the ball, working near the far corner, going up against Thomas. Big man battle, he jumps, and he's too short on the floater. Rebounded by Zane Martin, who's trying to go coast to coast. Splits two defenders for Delaware and finds the bucket.
Martin is a heavy left-hander. That means he is going to defer to his left hand at all times, especially when he's driving. Delaware's just got to level him off and send him back to his right hand and make him finish over the middle of the rim.
Towson has cut the deficit to 5 now. Delaware was up by 10 the last two possessions. Carter misses his shot, rebounded by Thomas. And here come the Tigers right to left once more. Lob pass into the corner to McNeil. He fakes a three, gives it to Martin. Now bounce passes it to Keith, and he travels. And Delaware will get the basketball.
Now that was Vintage Towson. They're sharing the ball, making a baseline pass back out, and then going inside. Unfortunately, the travel But Delaware's got to rally back and be a little bit more compressed in that zone.
We'll be right back with more. Another media timeout. You're listening to Blue Hens Basketball on 94.7 WDSD.
Whether you're a morning person or simply it's not your thing, maybe you're the type that doesn't take it that seriously. Or you're that person who just makes everyone's morning brighter. There's a McDonald's for every morning.
Enjoy a sausage burrito for $1 or a sausage McGriddle sandwich for $2. Pair it with any size freshly brewed McCafe hot coffee for $1.
Oh, say can you see 2 million bucks?
Lotto America is the new drawing game that's sweeping the nation. Get 6 numbers right, including the star ball, and you win. And with jackpots starting at $2 million, you win big. Lotto America from the Delaware Lottery. It's the new way to play and win the American dream.
And Bill, the pressure by the Delaware defense and the offense getting their pacing down, it's really thrown Towson off. However, the Tigers have been able to find a couple of scoring opportunities to get this back to a 5-point game. But overall, looking at it, Zane Martin, 11 minutes, he's just 1 for 6. That's certainly a good sign for Delaware.
It is a good sign, but the bad sign is he's had 2 or 3 really good looks the last 4 times down, and Delaware's got to do a much better job of getting organized defensively, get a hand in his face, chase him off the line, and make him play to his right hand. But you're right. I love the tempo. I love the way we've been playing defensively. We've been typically very active. We've also got to make sure we get back on defense a little bit quicker. Towson will exploit us, though they're not a transition, known as a transition team. Only 18% of their points come from that. But let's make sure we're back in front of them and then make them run their half-court sets.
Bryant with the basketball. Gives it out to Carter on top, who's back into the ball game after 2 early fouls this half. Mosley dribbles with his left, kicks it out. And the 3 is missed by Kyrie Walker, rebounded by Towson. And here comes Zane Martin and the Tigers.
I would love to see the ball reversed a couple more times before we take that long-range shot.
Starr gives it back to Martin on the top of the key. 7:18 ticking off the clock. Blue Hens still lead it by 5 here in the first half. Blue Hens looking to snap a 4-game losing streak. Starr for 3 from the left corner finds it.
I like Brian Starr's game. He allows the game to come to him. He plays at a nice pace. He's a distributor and a facilitator first, but he does have a very accurate shot from range. Delaware that time got confused with the top screening action and too much attention to Zane Martin.
Bryant with the basketball, gives it down to Walker, who tries to dribble. Now gives it over to Mosley on top of the key. 9 on the shot clock. He's bumped. Shot is no good, but he is fouled in the process.
Now that is vintage Anthony Mosley. Mosley in high school was a terrific athlete who could dominate play with not only his drives, but his ability to finish around the rim because he's so physical. And Anthony has improved his body throughout his career here at Delaware. He can absorb hits. He's very clever at finishing around the rim with both hands, even though he is a heavy left-handed player.
Mosley's first free throw is up and through. Mosley shooting 71%. From the charity stripe this season.
Corey, for those listeners that haven't been familiar, one of our players who comes in off the bench, Jacob Cushing, is playing with a mask. He's been playing with that since before the first of the year. His biggest issue, you would think it might be vision or breathing, but it's not. It's actually just the uncomfortableness of the straps supporting him, and he has a little trouble when he's close to the basket looking up and finding what's in front of him. We talked about that the other day, but he's really done a good job of playing through that difficulty.
That's certainly something to be going through as Alex Thomas finds the floater and Cushing adjusts those straps that you said that are uncomfortable.
Well, they are built to fit the individual, but sometimes, no matter what you do, they're still not going to be as good as obviously playing without it, but the straps are really important to have designed properly.
Cushing suffered a broken nose in practice back on December the 7th, hence the face guard. Blue Hens have the ball with 5 seconds left on the shot clock. Off the backboard is Anthony Mosley. Good shot there, high off the square.
Corey, you described that perfectly, and so many players do not utilize that glass. It's there for a reason. Anthony Mosley very smartly did that as he drove down the left side, softening up the shot.
Blue Hens up by four as we're near the 5.5 minute mark. Three is in and out off the hand of Mike Morcell. Here comes Ryan Allen and the Blue Hens. Allen dribbles with his left, now kicks it out to Mosley, who will slow things down for the Blue Hens.
That last possession is, the shot was taken by Morcell. A terrific high hand closeout by Darian Bryant facilitated that miss. He's really doing a nice job on Morcell, harassing him all over the court.
Allen with the ball again, needs help, kicks it out to Cushing for a deep three, and he misses, and it will go out of bounds. 5:04 remaining in the first half. Good defense by Towson. But again, Bill, Delaware really milking that shot clock, looking for their best shot possible. Right there, they just didn't really have a great look.
They're minimizing possessions. They're going to make this a game that's hopefully played in the high 50s and low 60s. Not the way Towson typically likes to play this year. This certainly works to Delaware's advantage, and I really like the job there. Even sometimes if we don't get the shot off close enough, the use of the clock is more important.
Martin kicks it out now, a three taken by Brian Starr, misses, and a great job by Sky Johnson battling for the rebound. And that was something we talked about, Bill, in the pregame. Delaware has to rebound against this very physical Towson team, and they're doing just that.
Put a body on a body, but more importantly, in zone, there are no assigned matchup blockouts, and Delaware's done a nice job of rotating, getting in the way of the big guys.
Bryant with the pivot jumper, no good. Johnson tried to go for the tip back, but Towson corrals a loose basketball.
Well, Towson will bring it down now. They'll run some ball screens against this zone.
D3 taken by Martin, no good. Rebounded, though, by Justin Gorham. He's trying to go up close, and it's blocked. But first, there's a foul called against Delaware.
Well, Gorham is very clever inside. I love the utilization of the shot fake. He has excellent footwork. I saw him working in practice for a young player. He's really developed some really good skills down low, and his body has improved as well. So he's going to be tough to deal with. That was a nice starting substitution, Gorham for Keith, that Pat Scarry threw out here to match Eric Carter and Sky Johnson.
Foul was on Darian Bryant, his first, Delaware's fifth. And the first free throw is missed by Towson's Justin Gorham, who's shooting 72% from the line.
Towson typically a good free throw shooting team. They shoot it over 70% at about 72. There are a couple guys in the end game you do not want to foul, and one of them is Morcell.
Gorham makes the second of the two, so he went 1-for-2 that trip. 3-point lead for Delaware. They have led as much as 10 points this half. Creeping up the 4-minute mark here in Newark, Delaware. Blue Hens and Towson battling it out here inside the Bob Carpenter Center. Allen with the ball. He's having a great year as a freshman. Cushing, good pass to Johnson with the reverse lay-in. Pretty play for Delaware.
Terrific spin pass by the lefty, Jacob Cushing, to get it into Sky Johnson, who did a great job of stepping off the defender down low and then finishing on the opposite side of the basket to protect against the shot block.
Gorham trying to beat Johnson to the hoop. Johnson stays put, and it's another board for Delaware. But talk about Cushing with that assist. He's played nicely, Bill, since coming in early in the ball game for Eric Carter.
He's very active, he's athletic, he's long, he can run the court, and I love it when he drives the ball.
There he is, driving with the left hand, and he gets the lay-in with the contact, no foul, and Cushing is starting to feel it here tonight.
And somehow Towson has forgotten that Jacob is left-handed, allowing him to get down the lane. But I love that finish there through contact. And when you finish through Towson players, you know you've done a tough guy play.
Deep corner three by Jordan McNeil, no good. Towson's Dennis Tunstall mistimed his jump, allowing Delaware to get the rebound. Here's Mosley going coast to coast. He misses the layup. A little bit of a erratic offering there. Now the game's starting to speed up. Towson can't keep control, and he just got a timeout, did Zane Martin.
Well, Zane Martin very fortunate there that that was not a walk, because he fell to the floor as he had lost his dribble, and typically that would be a traveling call.
Media timeout taken with 2:37 left in the first half. Blue Hens up by 7. You're listening to Blue Hens Game Day on 94.7 WDSD.
bigger doesn't mean stronger. Don't be defined by a weight class. Introducing the all-new Terrain, the compact SUV from GMC. Mighty like a pro. The all-new Terrain. Current lessees switch to GMC and get this low-mileage lease on this all-new 2018 Terrain SLE for around $249 per month with $999 due at signing.
We're home.
Let's go.
What kind of SUV is that?
It's a brand new Buick Enclave.
That really makes it easy to unload all those little maniacs.
Sure does.
Hey, honey, we should get one of those and have like a ton more kids.
Yeah, I love that. More kids.
Yeah.
Introducing the all-new Buick Enclave, tomorrow's SUV for today's family. Current Buick lessees get this low-mileage lease on this all-new 2018 Buick Enclave for around $399 per month.
It 24-17, and Bill, the Blue Hens defense shutting down Towson over the last 3 minutes and 55 seconds, but more importantly, shutting down one of the best scorers in the conference, Zane Martin, just 1-for-7 from the floor.
Zane Martin has had a terrific season scoring in the league. He's averaging over 21 points a game, only 1-for-7, but more importantly, a really good long-range shooter is 0-for-4, and that's part of the confusion against the zone. But also Delaware getting some high hand contests on Martin and speeding him up. He looks out of sorts tonight, and I credit that to Delaware's defense, the game plan, and the switch to zone.
Your stats recap courtside from the Value Days Fuel.com broadcast table. It's Value Days at participating Shell and Dash in stations throughout Delaware. 10 cents off on diesel every Monday, 20 cents off premium on Tuesday, and 5 cents off per gallon on all grades of gasoline each Thursday.
Now watch on the out of bounds underneath. Delaware's in a 2-3 zone. They've got to be a little careful as the ball enters in if they run a baseline weak play against the 2-3 zone and screen it.
Towson with the basketball. You're 2.5 minutes left in the first half. Blue Hens lead it by 7. Keith dribbles with his right, kicks it out now to Starr, who needs some help. Swings it over to Morcell on the left wing. Down to Keith. Spin around jumper by the line. No good. Pair of Tigers go up for the rebound, and that's Thomas with the putback for the bucket.
Thomas showed excellent discipline and patience there as he got the rebound. He located the defense. He waited for them to rise up and then attack with that big body.
Cushing with the pass to Johnson, but a foul is called against Towson. And it looks like it's against Alex Thomas, his second personal, team sixth.
Sky Johnson has already logged 15 minutes this half. That's a lot of minutes for Sky, but what he's done in practice and over the last month is get himself in better game shape. And I really credit him for hanging in there when he wasn't playing a lot, developing that additional aerobic conditioning, and a real factor here tonight.
Deep shot taken by Allen, misses. Here come the Tigers. Inside 2 minutes left in the first half. Cushing still on the floor. Eric Carter just 6 minutes played this game. And Cushing doubling that up after Carter had two early fouls. Cushing doing a great job. Here Keith doing a good job against Johnson, creating separation and gets the basket.
And he did that by attacking Sky Johnson's midsection, got him off balance, and then rose up with a little jump hook from about 6 feet. Eddie Keith, the second, doing a nice job in the middle of that zone attack against Delaware's 2-3 zone.
Towson pulls within three, inside a minute and a half here in the first half. Nice pass by Mosley. Johnson can't handle it, though, and has to kick it back out. Allen in the corner, 7 on the shot clock. Fadeaway jumper, no good. Gorham with the rebound. And Keith brings it up with his right hand for the Tigers. Across behind his back, no walk call. It's 2-on-1. Mosley with the basketball, lays it in with the finger roll. Timeout called. Blue Hens now back up by 5.
Well, a great job by Delaware transitioning there and sharing the ball. I was again surprised that wasn't a travel, but it was waved off as Eddie Keith tried to cross over in front of himself and then tripped himself and fell to the floor, and that created the turnover.
Delaware and Towson, 5-point differential. 1 minute left in the first half. Don't forget the Blue Hens halftime report presented by IBEW. Local 313 will be up in just a bit. Studio host Benny Pinella will get you the scores around the CAA, local and national. We'll also break it down here inside the Bob Carpenter Center. Right now, the Blue Hens lead it 26-21 and really just doing a great job limiting the Towson Tigers, especially their scoring threats in Marcel and Martin.
Terrific job of identifying the scores, as you've mentioned, getting out and extending, forcing them off shots that they normally get. But I think one of the keys has been how well Delaware has defended their defensive glass. This is a terrific offensive rebounding team. Towson and Delaware has minimized that. They haven't been hurt inside other than two offensive rebounds that have led to scores, and they themselves have done a good job working down in the paint. So Sky Johnson and limited minutes here for Eric Carter in the first half with those two fouls, has only played six. So Sky Johnson getting the bulk of those minutes from Eric Carter.
Delaware with 17 defensive rebounds. Brian Cushing swats the shot away, but now it's back in Towson's possession. Martin with the ball, seven on the shot clock, 37 seconds and counting. Swiped away by Mosley almost, and it's a high shot missed by Keith. And Bryant fights for the rebound, new shot clock for the Tigers. Going up with it is Gorham, and it looks like Johnson might have got a piece of him.
So many times those long rebounds are advantage to the offense because they have not left the area. The defense turns and looks in for the shot, trying to sag in there and congest the lane, especially against some big men that can offensive rebound, and the ball kicks out. Starr just a little quicker there and made a nice drop off pass to Gorham.
Johnson's second personal foul. Gorham with the free throw shot. It's up and through. Coming into the ball game for the Tigers, sophomore forward Dennis Tunstall for Keith.
Gorham, a very skilled player from Baltimore secondary school at Calvert Hall, which has a terrific program. They play games all over the East Coast and sometime nationally, even out on the West Coast. So this is, even though he's a sophomore, he's very skilled and a veteran player for as little time as he spent in college.
Gorham makes his second free throw. He's 3-for-4 now, had 7 points, leads Towson in that category. Delaware up by a tray with 27 seconds remaining. Cushing will inbound the ball.
Delaware going small here, Corey, with both Sky Johnson and Eric Carter out, but we should preserve and not shoot the ball until 4 seconds remain in the half.
Some pressure from Towson. Delaware gets it over the midcourt line. Cushing, who I called Brian, having the Super Bowl on my mind. It is Jacob Cushing. Mosley dribbles with his left, 5 seconds on the clock. Spins, switches hands, lefty lay-in, and it falls through, and the clock expires. And that will end the first half. Head coach for Delaware, Martin Inglesby, loves what he sees from Mosley, and the Blue Hens will take a 5-point cushion going into half.
Great energy, a terrific finish there to the half, doing just what we talked about, scoring literally with no time left on the clock. A great spin reversed by Anthony Mosley, working back to his left hand, and boy, he is so tough at finishing through contact. A great end of the half for Delaware.
Certainly was. Delaware leads it 28-23. Stay tuned. The Blue Hens halftime report presented by IBEW Local 313 coming up next with Benny Pinnell. He'll have all the...
Puts it into the post to Nick Harrison.
We've all been there.
I can't even see the score.
Oh my God.
Trying to watch the game on that tiny screen. It's time to watch sports the way they were meant to be watched. On this, in high definition. You can now watch all your favorite teams and players on the big screen for free. With CAA.TV, you'll never miss a moment. Take back the living room by searching CAA on your device.
Every day's a chance to flip the script, an invitation to take everything we know and reinvent it. It takes courage. It's an obsession, never settling for just good enough. It takes a true creator to make something out of nothing. It takes guts. Calling all creators, those who see obstacles as a chance to win bigger. Calling all creators, the game changers, the difference makers, the boundary breakers, the tomorrow takers. Calling all creators, get up, invent, adapt, write new rules. Calling all creators, it's a new day, create something.
Rush hour. Or relax hour, it's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
The official bird of Delaware isn't red. It's not green or purple. It's blue. Coincidence? We think not. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield, Delaware. This blue hen does not need to see a podiatrist. But if he did, waiting for a referral might get his feathers in a bunch. And he wouldn't like that one bit. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield, Delaware.
Hi guys, it's great to be here.
In the desert.
At the mall.
On the mountain.
At school.
At the beach.
In the Big Easy.
Yeah.
Today I want to show you guys the next gen Chevy Equinox. What do you think?
That's pretty.
Pretty sexy.
It's all wheel drive, look at that.
It looks aggressive.
But not overbearing.
It's not too big, not too small.
Looks like it could go off-roading.
But at the same time, it looks like a car you could take to a nice event.
You can dress it up or dress it down.
Seems like the perfect car for anybody.
I would take it anywhere.
I want one.
I love it.
She's a bad mamma jamma.
Chevy stepped their game up.
Whether you're a morning person or simply it's not your thing. Maybe you're the type that doesn't take it that seriously. Or you're that person who just makes everyone's morning brighter. There's a McDonald's for every morning.
Enjoy a sausage burrito for $1 or a sausage McGriddle sandwich for $2. Pair it with any size freshly brewed McCafe hot coffee for $1.
America is the new drawing game that's sweeping the nation. Get six numbers right, including the star ball, and you win. And with jackpots starting at $2 million, you win big. Lotto America from the Delaware Lottery. It's the new way to play and win the American dream.
Bigger doesn't mean stronger. Don't be defined by a weight class. Introducing the all-new Terrain, the compact SUV from GMC. Mighty like a pro. The all-new Terrain. Current lessees switch to GMC and get this low-mileage lease on this all-new 2018 Terrain SLE for around $249 per month with $999 due at signing.
We're home.
Let's go.
What kind of SUV is that?
It's a brand new Buick Enclave.
That really makes it easy to unload all those little maniacs.
Sure does.
Hey, honey, we should get one of those and have like a ton more kids.
Yeah, I love that. More kids.
Yeah.
Introducing the all-new Buick Enclave. Tomorrow's SUV for today's family. Current Buick lessees, get this low-mileage lease on this all-new 2018 Buick Enclave for around $399 per month.
Tigers of Towson 23, Corey Nido in for the voice of the Blue Hen, Scott Klatskin, alongside Bill Harmon. And Bill talked about the physicality that Delaware would need to face this Tigers team. how to keep Martin and Morcell off the scoreboard. Right now, Delaware checking both those boxes off.
Absolutely. Delaware has not only matched the intensity of Towson, I think they've actually competed even better than Towson. Towson completely out of rhythm offensively. Now, the bad news from Delaware's standpoint is Towson not having a good shooting night, 28% from the field, and their good scores having bad games, and they're only down five. Now, that's what you would expect, though. Towson favored in this game, and I think Delaware has really competed well. They've done exactly what they needed to do with the game plan. The inclusion of the 2-3 zone, I think, has really frustrated them. Delaware's been tough in the open court. They've attacked that pressure when they've had to and done a nice job with that. And let's not forget, Eric Carter only logged 6 minutes, and he's been playing at a very high level. Delaware doing a good job also, Corey, of taking care of the ball. Only 4 turnovers, and 2 of those were on the offensive fouls that Eric Carter incurred.
Absolutely. You mentioned Eric Carter not playing much, but how about the guy who's stepping in, Jacob Cushing? The box score won't wow you by any means. 1 for 4 from the floor. Has 2 total rebounds, but he's just playing good defense. Had a nice assist earlier in the game, and you have to like what you're seeing from Cushing if you're Martin Inglesby.
He's very active. He's gaining confidence, and you only gain confidence, as we talked about in the pregame show, from actually having your performance show it out on the court. He's gotten better in practice, and it's carrying over. He has 2 assists. He had a nice block inside on a contest of one of Gorham's shots. I thought he's played well in the open court. I love it when he drives the ball to the basket. I think he needs to show a few more shot fakes, get into the lane. Towson right now very vulnerable to Delaware's driving. Mosley, Bryant, and Cushing have all exploited Towson's man-to-man by driving the ball on straight line efforts and getting to the foul line. That's one of the things that Delaware needs to do a little bit more in the second half. They're shooting 100% from the foul line, but only 3 for 3, and also keeping Towson off, who is a volume free throw shooting team, only has 4 attempts. So a good job by both teams defending without fouling.
Take a look at some of your leaders for Delaware. Ryan Allen, Anthony Mosley lead the way with 10 points apiece. And then you have Sky Johnson with 4. For Towson, we talked about Zane Martin, Mike Morcell, the 2 top scorers for the Tigers. Well, they have been held to just 7 points and a combined 3 for 12 from the field. Overall, Towson out-rebounding Delaware, but not by much, 22-20, and Delaware really taking care of the ball on the defensive side of the glass, getting 17 boards. And right now, the Blue Hens looking to snap a 4-game losing streak. Bill, what do they need to do in the second half here to ensure that they walk out of here victorious?
Well, they need to continue to get back in transition. They've got to keep the ball out of the post, especially with Thomas and Gorham when he's in there. And obviously, they need to run Zane Martin off, keep him out of rhythm. I like the job that Anthony Mosley's done, and maybe in some switches, especially if Likes out on the perimeter, Darian Bryant can play Martin. Morcell and Martin may get some of theirs, but they've got to be hard-earned. We've got to make them work through their own shot clock. And then at the other end, let's go through Eric Carter and Sky Johnson in the post and see if we can't punish Towson down low and continue to block out and rebound effectively on the defensive glass.
Second half begins with Towson getting the ball moving left to right under Dial. Gorham has the ball down the left block, tries to go over Johnson, and Johnson is called for the foul.
Well, the issue there was, Corey, instead of going straight up with both arms by your ears so you do not violate the principle of verticality, unfortunately, Sky leaned in with his left arm and caught him on the elbow as he went up. You've just got to make a player like Gorham score over top of you.
Gorham 3 for 4 from the line here tonight, looking to pull Towson within a couple of points. Down by 5 are the Tigers, and Gorham sinks his first.
I like Gorham's rhythm offensively. He plays at a really good pace. He never seems to be in a hurry, uses shot fakes effectively, has excellent footwork, and looks to me like he's a very fine free throw shooter. He's got terrific rotation on his shot.
Gorham went to the same high school as former Towson great Gary Neal, NBA All-Rookie back in 2011. It looks like there's a delay in play. It looks like the ref is wiping off the basketball with a white Gatorade towel. Looks like something got on the rock. It's 28-24 here, just a few seconds into the second half. Delaware fighting hard against Towson. Now Gorham will step to the line to complete his second free throw. Crowd gets loud. Bent at the knees, up and through, and he sinks both.
Well, Towson will continue to show some full court pressure. Right now, it's not in a quick trap nature. They're just trying to slow Delaware down, so when they start against their offense at the half court set, they're left with about 20 seconds.
Blue Hens get it across. 19 seconds on the play clock. Mosley gives it down, and now Johnson has the ball. Reverse laying high up the glass, no good. Gorham with the board for Towson.
A great idea there, slipping the screen with Sky Johnson, but he's got to be able to stabilize himself and finish better.
Martin tried to go with the acrobatic laying through traffic. Ball goes out of bounds. It looks like Martin's forcing a lot of shots here tonight.
You're absolutely right. He has made an adjustment. Instead of settling for the three or the long range two, he's trying to drive it, but he's been off balance. And Delaware's big men have done a nice job of bodying him slightly and contesting those shots.
Blue Hens lead it by three as we approach 19 minutes remaining in the ball game. Martin now just 1 for 8 from the floor. Carter with the basketball. Lost where he was, looked like underneath the hoop, gets a turnover to Towson, and here come the Tigers left to right. Ball gives to Gorham, now hands it off to Martin, who will slow things down. 15 on the shot clock. Martin dribbles with his right, kicks it out to Thomas, who airmails the jumper, but there is Gorham on the offensive board. 8 on the shot clock. Spin around jumper, nice arcing shot, finds the bottom of the mesh.
Well, Sky Johnson actually had a body on Gorham, but the shot was missed so badly by Thomas that he did not have a chance to snap his head, and then Gorham with a nice turnaround shot to his right shoulder, fading away over Sky Johnson's extended arm.
Blue Hens lead down to just a single tally. Mosley drives, floats with the left hand, beautiful shot, and Mosley's bucket puts the Blue Hens back up by three.
The key to that shot was Anthony Mosley's ability to elevate and be on balance as he released that floater. A good job with his body control.
18 minutes left here in the ball game. Towson moving left to right. It is Morsell with the ball. He tries to go left-handed with the lay-in, misses it. Gorham misses the second chance, and there's Eric Carter with the rebound, and the home faithful giving a round of applause for Carter's work. Carter now finishes it on the other end. Ryan Allen with the nice assist, and the Blue Hens up 32-27.
Towson allowing Allen to get into the lane, going right to left with his left hand, and then a terrific drop-off pass to the weak side. There had been no rotation from the top part of Towson's man-to-man to accommodate for Eric Carter, who lays it in easily.
Foul is called, and it is against Towson. Offensive foul off ball against Gorham, his second personal, team's first of the second half.
One of the points of emphasis with the officials throughout this 2017-18 season is the moving screens. And that time it was actually more of the fault of the ball handler than the screener, because the ball cannot be going to the screener if he's still moving.
Mosley with the basketball for the Blue Hens. Carter, top of the key, has both hands on the rock, looking to give it down to Sky Johnson. He swings it back out to Bryant near the left wing, dribbles with his right, getting double teamed a little bit, and now it is a foul called against Towson.
Towson University foul call 23.
It will be on number 23, Mike Morsell, his first personal, team second. Go ahead, Bill.
Morsell hand checking Darian Bryant as he was dribbling left to right. There really wasn't much going on with that play, but a good job by Bryant kind of playing through that contact. Occasionally, Delaware has the mismatch with Keith, 3 inches shorter than Sky Johnson. The ball needs to go into Sky Johnson on the block.
Allen with the ball, dribbles, feeds it down to Johnson on the left block, off the glass, and right there, Bill, you said it, it's successful.
A nice job by Ryan Allen, understanding the matchup advantage that Sky Johnson has, and a nice finish there by Sky Johnson on the left side using his right hand.
Blue Hens back up by 7, 16 and a half minutes left in the game, and a three good by Zane Martin.
The game plan has been to go underneath the ball screens at distance. Unfortunately, Zane Martin has the capability of pulling up behind it, so Delaware may need to change that strategy, get over the top or hard hedge it with the screener's defender.
Allen with the basketball. He has 10 points for the Blue Hens tonight. Bryant dribbles, feeds it down to Carter, who stutter steps, ball fakes, now moves over to the middle of the center. Off the left block, fouled, makes the shot, plus one.
I've been waiting for Eric Carter to go to the middle and drop step. Then he gets the defender at a bad angle, and he can finish over top either using his left hand or literally facing up as he did there. Thomas, not known for his jumping ability, he tries to stay flat on the ground to make Eric Carter score over him, and Eric Carter's length allows him to do that.
Carter will go to the line and try and complete the three-point play, shooting 62% from the line this season. Carter has 6 points in 10 minutes. Again, he had those two early fouls, completes the three-point play, and Delaware's lead back up to 7. 16:07 remaining in the ball game. Delaware looking to snap that four-game losing streak before they travel down to Elon. 5 of the last 7 games will be on the road for Delaware. Some pressure by Mosley in the backcourt. Now here comes Towson. Martin gets the second bounce. Went through a lot of traffic again, Bill, but there it gets the lucky shooter's roll.
Well, Martin entered the lane with his right hand, but he has the ability to rise up and shoot that left-hand floater. Did a good job of using the backboard there in the back part of the rim to soften up the shot. Martin now starting to get on track. Delaware may want to change the matchup or change the defensive posture on him.
Mosley dribbles with his right, getting man coverage, try to find Allen, cutting to the basket. Ball goes out of bounds, and now the refs will have a quick meeting to see who last touched it, and it will be Towson's basketball. So Delaware leads 37-32. Media timeout coming up. You're listening to Blue Hens Basketball on 94.7 WDSD.
Once it into the post to Nick Harrison.
We've all been there.
Can't even see the score. Oh my God.
Trying to watch the game on that tiny screen. It's time to watch sports the way they were meant to be watched. On this, in high definition. You can now watch all your favorite teams and players on the big screen for free. With CAA.TV, you'll never miss a moment. Take back the living room by searching CAA on your device.
Rush hour or relax hour, it's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
University of Delaware, Star Health, a new direction in healthcare. In the pregame, Bill, it was Zane Martin, your star to watch. And right now, Delaware is still doing a good job containing one of the top scorers in the conference. Just 7 points, 3 for 10 from the floor.
Yes, but unfortunately, from Delaware's perspective, he started to heat up here. Delaware sunk underneath the screen. He pulled up and shot the long range three, and then his ability to get into the lane. You've got to level out a player like Martin. You've got to make him shoot over a high hand contested. And at times, you may want to double team him when he's involved in the pick and roll, not to allow him to be A, able to turn the corner and get into the lane, and B, pull up and shoot that shot. So let's see if Delaware doesn't adjust. A nice substitution, giving Sky Johnson a little bit of rest. Jacob Cushing back in the game.
Cushing has been busy tonight, filling in for Eric Carter, but the two of them are on the hardwood for the Blue Hens as play will resume. Delaware leads it by 5, 37-32, 15.5 remaining in the contest.
Delaware playing man-to-man this half. They do have that 2-3 zone in their back pocket, which troubled Towson in the first half.
Martin dribbles with his right, Mosley guarding him closely. Martin spins around, switches hands to his left, now kicks it out to Keith. Keith dribble drives, tries to power his way forward, and makes the lay-in for the Tigers.
We talked about the physicality earlier on. A player like Eddie Keith looks to me like a linebacker. 6'5", 240, the senior, really has a terrific basketball body, and that time just kind of bullied his way into the lane and scored over Jacob Cushing. Not bad defense, but better offense by Keith.
Delaware with the basketball, 14 on the shot clock. Mosley on the near left corner, gives it to Allen, who has a trio of threes tonight. Allen floats it with his left hand, no foul. And it's rebounded by Martin. Looked like Allen might have gotten bumped on that shot.
I couldn't agree with you more. Allen's got to maybe act that out a little bit more.
Martin's three wide to the right of the basket. His struggles continue this evening. And now here comes Mosley slowing it down right to left on the dial.
I'm not sure the Pat Scarry Tufts graduate would have liked that shot. He's a point guard himself, a very savvy competitor. That shot by Martin, who's trying to get on track here, just came way too early in the shot clock with that one pass.
Towson is called for the foul. Jordan McNeil, his second personal. Team's fourth in the second half. 14-14 left in the ballgame. Delaware battling Towson. Blue Hens looking to end their three-game homestand on the victorious side. Up by three, looking to pad that. 19 on the shot clock. Bryant has the rock on the top of the key near the Blue Hen center court. Allen dribbles, good feet to Bryant. Wing from the three, no good. And the ball goes out of bounds. It'll be Tigers basketball.
That was terrific defense by Mike Marcel, who helped off of Darian Bryant as it looked like Ryan Allen was going to turn the corner with his left hand. That's what Towson is really good at. They play good help defense. They're very physical and are really connected with their communication on defense.
Mike Marcel works from the point, now gives it to Martin. Martin dribbles with his right, trying to go through a couple defenders, feeds it over to Dennis Tunstall, who's fouled on the shot. And it looks like it was on Ryan Allen. And it was his first personal, team second of the second half. And going to the line is Tunstall.
I like it when your leading scorer, who's a little out of rhythm, is willing to drive the ball and then set up teammates. He caught Delaware in a help-up situation. That allowed Tunstall to step in on a quick close-the-door fashion where you get your outside foot and shoulder turn very quickly to avoid the shot block. Nice technique there by the Williamsburg, New Jersey native Dennis Tunstall.
Couple substitutions. Mosley back in for Delaware. Bryant Starr in for Towson. And the ball will go the other way. Looked like it was a foul. Couldn't see the number from the official.
It's on Mike Marcel, who tried to get in early into the lane and actually threw Jacob Cushing down on the ground. A good call by the officiating crew.
Team's fifth foul here in the second half. Blue Hens up 37-34. We talked about them controlling the pace of the game, Bill. Towson averaging 77.5 points per game. This is certainly not what they're used to seeing.
Absolutely not. They've been scoring in the 90s. They've been in the free flow, fluid condition, and now Delaware has slowed them up using the clock, but also really playing aggressive defense.
Off ball foul with 8 on the shot clock. Looks like it was against Eddie Keith against Towson. His first personal, team sixth. And now coming back into the for the Tigers, Justin Gorham, as Tunstall will take a seat. New shot clock. It will go to at least 20 seconds now for the Blue Hens. Carter with the basketball, dribbles left block, now looking for some help. Still needs it. Finally gets it from Mosley in the left corner. 11 on the shot clock. Nearing the 13-minute mark. Mosley high off the glass, no good. Ran into a body of Towson, and here comes the Tigers with Marcel leading the charge. Stop, jump stop, and good by Marcel. Good job there by the forward.
Marcel is really tough in the open court. He loves to drive the ball. He took it left to right. He knew the Delaware defense was not established. They backed up on him, and he attacks through them and scores.
Towson back to within a point against Delaware. Blue Hens have had a lead as large as 10. Allen goes to the hoop, left-handed lay-in, smooth as can be. And the lead back up to 3 for the Blue Hens.
He does a great job, does Ryan Allen, identifying angles and straight line drive opportunities. That time he went in from left to right, worked through a shot blocker and finished.
Towson with the answer. Bryant Starr with the right-handed lay-in. It was pretty easy. Gorham with the assist.
Well, they ran Ryan Allen off a back pick, and Delaware did not communicate. Look for them maybe to go back to some zone here, possibly at the next timeout, media timeout, or even in transition here. Towson beginning to get in rhythm against Delaware's man-to-man.
It's been a good game so far. 12 minutes left in it. Bryant trying to force a shot too hard off the back iron. And here comes Towson looking for their first lead since the first half. And the shooter is fouled. It was Gorham going to the hoop. And it looked like it was on Cushing. Jacob Cushing. His second personal and team's third. Media timeout. Blue Hens clinging to a one-point lead inside 12 minutes remaining in the ballgame. You're listening to Blue Hens Game Day on 94.7 WDSD.
Every day's a chance. A chance to flip the script. An invitation to take everything we know and reinvent it. It takes courage. It's an obsession. Never settling for just good enough. It takes a true creator to make something out of nothing. It takes guts. Calling all creators. Those who see obstacles as a chance to win bigger. Calling all creators. The game changers, the difference makers, the boundary breakers, the tomorrow takers. Calling all creators. Get up. Invent. Adapt. Write new rules. Calling all creators. It's a new day. Create something.
Live from Klondike Kate's on Main Street. The next show will be Monday, February 12th. And remember, every time the Blue Hens basketball team wins, bring in your ticket stub or share the final score graphic on social media, and you'll receive 20% off dinner the next day. Blue Hens up 39-38 coming outside of this media timeout. And Bill, Towson starting to figure it out a little bit, opposed to the first half where they were really searching for answers.
They've done some better screening action. They've caught Delaware a little slow getting back on defense. They themselves have done a much better job of blocking out on the defensive glass. Delaware's last three shots, they've had no one within 10 feet of getting an offensive rebound. So Delaware's got to commit a little bit more to shooting it later in the shot clock. They've got to make sure we get good shots and have people underneath where we can at least challenge for an offensive rebound. Let's look to see if Martin Inglesby doesn't change the configuration of the defense and play some more of that 2-3 zone that was so successful in the first half.
Kyrie Walker in the ball game for Delaware. Gorham back to the line. If he makes his free throw, it will tie the game up. Crowd gets loud, the shot is up and it is good. 39 all, and it's the first time tonight, Bill, since the game was at a 4-4 tie that we've been knotted up.
Well, let's credit Pat Scarry with a smart substitution here, playing Gorham a lot this evening, and he's really answered his coach's clarion call by contributing 13 points already, doing a great job at the foul line, 7-for-8.
Gorham makes the second now. Towson has their first lead since way back in the early stages of the first half when it was a 4-3 Tigers lead. Delaware is familiar with that situation, led for 33 minutes Thursday against Hofstra, unable to come out with the win. Looking to try and not repeat that here. Carter down on the right block this time, 6 on the shot clock, going against Gorham. Ryan and Layin, good and one.
Much better patience by Delaware. Going inside to Eric Carter, who's got the matchup advantage. A good job of turning this time on the right side of the lane to his left shoulder, which facilitates a bank shot. And he did a great job of knowing exactly what angle he had to release that and played through some contacts. That was a terrific offensive possession by Delaware.
Carter will try to complete the three-point play, and he does. Lead back up to a pair for Delaware. 42-40. Inside 11 and a
half. Delaware in that 2-3 zone, out of the timeout. A great change up here by Martin Inglesby and the staff.
Certainly was giving Towson fits in the first half. Towson looking to feed it down low. Good cut by Martin. A good feed by Gorham as well. And the Tigers answer back. And we're all tied up 42-42.
Offensively, you should not be able to backdoor a 2-3 zone due to the fact there are three players along the baseline, but Towson got the middle of the zone to rise up, got our wingman too far extended, and a good job of working that baseline back door against the zone.
Bryant feeds Carter on the right block. Now Bryant back on top of the key. Head fake, spin around. Can't get the roll in. It was a good shot by Bryant getting some room. Just couldn't get it to fall.
His old friend Marcel did a nice job there of contesting that shot, but I love Bryant's attack.
Marcel now spins, jumps, and he can't get the lay in. They're fighting for it. Ball's volleyed into the net. And Justin Gorham with the putback. You mentioned that cool dynamic between Bryant and Martin. Childhood friends since they were 7. Went to the same high school, but tonight they're enemies.
Well said, and they're really competing hard. And I do like interesting stories. They're both from St. John's College High School in Washington, D.C.
Looks like a full timeout taken by Delaware. 44-42, Tigers lead. And Bill, if you're the Blue Hens, you don't want to panic, but that Hofstra game might be sneaking in the back of their mind where they were leading for the majority of the game just like they are in this one, and the Tigers just not going away.
And here's where Martin Inglesby is going to be really smart. He's going to use some timeouts. A lot of coaches want to keep their timeouts as if they're gold for the end game. Well, you can lose the game right at these marks, and I think Delaware right now looks a little fatigued. They need to get their slides down on that 2-3 zone and do a better job of blocking out. Towson looks more to be the aggressor now. They've hurt Delaware on the offensive glass. They've driven down the middle of the zone, and they've also defended there. So I think this is a very cagey timeout by the veteran point guard from Notre Dame, taking time here to not only talk to his charges, but also settle them down and get some energy back.
Take a look at the box score. Your leading scorer of the game is Justin Gorham, who has 15 points, 4-for-9 from the floor, but more importantly, 7-of-8 from the free throw line. He also has 11 rebounds, so a double-double for Gorham. For Delaware, it's Allen and Mosley pacing the offense for the Blue Hens, 12 points each. And then you also have Eric Carter with 10 points starting to heat up here in the second half. He had to miss the majority of the first half with 2 early fouls. Both teams shooting relatively near the same percentage. Delaware 40% from the floor, Towson 37. But right now, as you mentioned, Bill, Martin Inglesby trying to draw something up and also try and calm down this team that has went from rather experienced with some of the players in Daly and Anderson, although a freshman Anderson was just playing lights out, to an inexperienced team with not a lot of depth.
And let's see if we don't come back with the big man rotation, get both Eric Carter and Sky Johnson in. That'll help on the glass, that'll help offensively, where we can still go out on the perimeter and play some high-low against this very difficult Towson man-to-man. And also just see if we can't send a message, hey, we're not going to back down from you guys, and we're going to battle you on the glass. And in fact, that is the substitution, Sky back in the game along with Eric Carter.
Blue Hens looking to snap that 4-game losing streak. Battling here in Newark, Delaware against the Tigers of Towson. Delaware down 44-42, 10-18 remaining here in the ball game. Waiting.
Delaware has 21 seconds to work here. Plenty of time to run some sets. Let's see if we don't get a high-low, or see if we can get Brian Allen coming off a stagger.
Bryant inbounds it right in front of us, courtside, gives it to Mosley. Mosley dribbles with his left, being guarded by Brian Starr. Allen gets the ball, but it's an off-ball foul against Delaware, and that will give Towson the basketball.
Delaware, in fact, was running a weak side stagger for Ryan Allen, and I think they caught Darian Bryant just moving on that screen. Again, a point of emphasis, just be set. Don't shift any part of your body. Let the man using the screen run close to it, hip to hip, shoulder to shoulder.
Bryant's second personal foul. Blue Hens down by 2, inside 10 minutes remaining. Starr with the ball, kicks it out now to the far corner where Eddie Keith has it. High floater off the glass, and he's fouled. Carter and Gorham got tangled up a little bit, both arms going up.
I think that's going to be a foul on Sky Johnson. And unfortunately, Sky just being overly aggressive there. Eddie Keith was going in completely out of control. I think that was a degree of difficulty at about 10 on that shot that almost had no opportunity to go in. You don't want to, as a defender, bail out an out-of-control driver.
Johnson's third personal foul. Keith has the first free throw, roll around and find the bottom of the net. Extends the Tigers' lead to 3.
And when Towson gets in trouble, instead of settling for long-range shots, they will throw the ball into the post or drive it, get to the foul line more often, and get to that double bonus sooner. And that's one thing right now that Towson is playing to their strengths.
Keith misses the second one, so it's still a 3-point game, one possession for Delaware. Delaware has struggled shooting beyond the arc this season, not really their game right now. Mosley, chest pass over to Bryant, who feeds it down to Carter on the right block. Has both hands on the rock, dribbles with his left, backing down. Keith loses control of the ball. Mosley gets it, but he steps out of bounds, and it will be Towson's basketball.
Unfortunately, Eric Carter, as he went up into his right shoulder turn, left-hand jump hook, just lost the ball. It's got to be secured with both hands. You want to use that inside arm, in that case his right arm, to push the ball up. He had it drop off a little too soon. He's got to be able to score there in that one-on-one action. Towson is not even digging in. They're making him score against individual defense.
Blue Hens still trail by 3. nearing the 9-minute mark here in the ball game. Martin dribbles, high dribble now, gives it down low to Gorham. Good feed and pretty finish for the Tigers.
Boy, Gorham has been exceptional, finding places to spot up in that lane. And credit Zane Martin, who's having trouble scoring, but becoming a facilitator now, setting up his teammate.
Towson now up to their biggest lead of the ball game, 47-42, 5-point differential for the Blue Hens. Pass is almost intercepted by Gorham, goes down low now to Johnson, who lays it in the glass with both hands.
Good job by Sky, turning in, locating exactly where he was and finishing through contact. Sky and Eric Carter are two big men in the game, really need to start taking over, doing a good job on the defensive glass and also posting up and getting scoring opportunities at the offensive end.
Martin with the jumper, 17 feet out, misses. Keith with the rebound and is blocked by Carter, and he grabs the rebound over Keith. Keith wants a foul, and now he's teed up.
Well, what a big turn of events there. Eric Carter just refused to give in to Eddie Keith and did a great job of ripping that ball out of his hands. That's something Towson's familiar with. That time Eric Carter responds, and now Keith very upset about not getting an over-the-back call.
That bucket by Johnson broke a 7-0 run from Towson, and now Keith getting teed up, and it will be Ryan Allen shooting the technicals for Delaware. This is what the Blue Hens need, down by three, kind of get momentum back into their sails as the Towson Tigers have figured the defense out of Delaware for the time being, but Blue Hens pesky, Bill, not going away.
Well, they certainly aren't. We've hung in there. That's a play by Eddie Keith the second you just can't make as a senior. You've got to be more experienced. You've got to be poised. You've got to just control your emotions, because in a close game, these kind of plays might be the difference maker. And it does give Delaware an opportunity here to score without the clock running, but also get some more momentum.
Allen makes the first technical. He's 2 for 2 from the line, now has 13 points tonight, leading the Delaware Blue Hens.
And I like the job Pat Scarry did. Not something of anger as much as get your senior out, settle him down so he can't hurt you again. Take a look at the game. And he substitutes Star for Eddie Keith the second. A nice play there by the savvy veteran coach, Pat Scarry.
Delaware back within a point, 47-46. Have the ball moving right to left on your dial. Darian Bryant being guarded against Mike Morsell. Gives it down to Carter, who's starting to feel it. Allen gets the 3-point look, and he knocks it through, and he's feeling it as Eric Carter assists him on another tray.
The ball going into the post so many times is misunderstood. You don't have to score in there. A good big man is an excellent passer, and he rewards his teammate for working hard off the ball. Coming to the ball side was Ryan Allen, and lifts up over top of Starr.
Delaware back up by two. Here's a three taken by Towson, and the Tigers answer with a three from Mike Morsell.
Talk about a veteran play. Mike Morsell, when things get close, is willing to take big shots. He's only averaging 13 points, but he shoots at 37% from the three. That was a wonderful stroke with a tough contest by Darian Bryant coming.
50-49, Delaware back down by a point. Back and forth we go here in the second half. Allen, deep three again, and it's good! Ryan Allen heating up from downtown tonight.
Rhythm shooter, streak shooter who has good streaks. Ryan Allen finds his spots, does a great job of elevating over top of the defense.
That put electric in this crowd here at the Bob Carpenter Center. That's the fifth three made by Allen. He had three early in the first half. Here's another three by Towson, no good. And there he is, Ryan Allen, starting to put on a show here.
The difference was there is Morsell's shot. That was not Darian Bryant at 6'4 closing him out. It was 6'8 Eric Carter. That 4 inches many times changes the trajectory.
Bryant feeds Carter in the post, gives it to Allen. Took his eye off the pass this time. And there's Starr to scoop up the loose ball. Now Towson pushing the pace. Martin going up with the shot. He gets fouled. And the shot will count. And a good job by Martin. And right there, just understanding the situation.
Martin there kind of had the extra step, almost like a dubstep, syncopated bass percussion. One of the alums from Towson, Joe Nice, is a dubstep DJ. He would really have appreciated that play.
We'll take a timeout, media timeout, all tied up at 52-52, 6:29 remaining in the ballgame on Blue Hens game day.
Once into the post to Nick Harrison.
We've all been there.
Can't even see the score. Oh my God.
Trying to watch the game on that tiny screen. It's time to watch sports the way they were meant to be watched. On this. high definition. You can now watch all your favorite teams and players on the big screen for free. With CAA.TV, you'll never miss a moment. Take back the living room by searching CAA on your device.
Scorer for Towson has 11 points, so he will continue his streak of 18 consecutive games with double digits. Shot is up, and it clanks off the back of the iron, so misses there. Carter with the board. Game remains tied 52 apiece. Mosley, chest pass to Cushing, who's back in the game. He's had a nice night tonight. Bryant now dribbles with his right, being guarded by Martin. Here's Allen, who has 8 of the last points for Delaware. Mosley feeds it down to Carter, a little bit of a wild pass. He corrals it, right-handed hook, no contact called, and now here comes Towson. Martin, spin around lay-in, can't go, and it's bottled up there, and it's Gorham, and now some pushing and shoving, and it looked like, I can't see if somebody just got teed up, but Carter looked like he was just helping Gorham up.
Well, he was helping him up, and I think that's a really bad call by the officials unless something else went on that I didn't see. Eric Carter went over the top trying to block the shot. It was a basketball play, and then Gorham falls to the floor, and one of the officials calls a quick technical there as Eric Carter actually leaned down to try to help him up was the way I saw it, Corey.
I did too, so the officials are trying to situate it near midcourt. We'll see what the ruling is. It's a tied game, 52-52, 5:55 remaining in the ball game. Getting physical, which we expected, Bill, talking about it in the pregame. That's how Towson plays. We're still waiting to see as the officials will look to the monitor. From our vantage point, I thought Carter was just trying to help him up. He wasn't trying to instigate anything.
Well, we'll have to see as the officials adjudicate over there. One thing I like, though, is Zane Martin wheeled down the lane. He was out of control. Delaware did not bail him out with a foul. Unfortunately, at that point, you've got to turn and locate one of those post players, a player like Gorham, and get your body on him. Gorham was allowed to slip in and get great position for that rebound, which resulted in the foul. And then the whatever we're going to find out here from the officials, the inordinate physical play, but I like the way Delaware has responded. They're not backing down from Towson. They're matching every physical play, and I thought that was a solid basketball play, not a dirty play at all.
So we're still waiting on the officials. Blue Hens looking to end a four-game skid and pull back to 500 with a victory. They would win if they were to win tonight. They'd be 12-12 on the season, 5-6, and a very packed CAA, Bill. A lot of teams, there's not much separation from the top and the middle of the pack.
That's what makes this league so much fun to call and to watch game in and game out. It's not a top-heavy league, and it's not a bottom-heavy league. The low team, Drexel, has done a great job of defending their home court against teams like College of Charleston. and Hofstra. So this is a league that we're ranked 12th in the RPI, which is one lower than we've been over the last couple of years, but that's only because our out-of-conference strength of schedule was not quite as strong. But I really like the way that the conference has, I think, molded itself in and very balanced. Anybody can win any night.
So we got the ruling. It was a foul called against Carter, his third, but the technical win against Zane Martin.
Now that makes sense to me. I did not think that call should have been against Eric Carter. I thought he did actually a very sportsmanlike maneuver to reach down and help Gorham up.
So Gorham makes the first shot. That's two technicals by Towson and not too much of a span here in the second half. So frustration maybe and some tension boiling on the Towson bench.
Well, I think you've described it perfectly. And though Zane Martin's only a sophomore, he's played enough to understand that in a close game like this, you cannot give any free points to the opposition. And Ryan Allen, a terrific free throw shooter, goes to the line here to take advantage of a loss of poise by Zane Martin.
Allen perfect in three trips to the foul line. Make it 4-for-4. And also Justin Gorham really capitalizing at the charity stripe as well for Towson. 9 of 10, 9 of his 19 points coming from there.
Well, good job by Ryan Allen making all four technical foul shots so far. So Delaware continues to hang in there and respond no matter what mode it is in. And a good job here by Martin Inglesby keeping his team contained in terms of their emotions.
Fourth tie as it's 54 all between Delaware and Towson. After those two free throws, Bill, Allen has scored the last 10 points for UD. He has been quite the show here in the second half. Cushing gets the ball, a spin pass, got knocked away. Here comes Towson on the other end. It's Morsell with the reverse lay-in, and he finds the bottom of the net, and Towson back up by a pair.
At 6'5", Morsell is very long. His arms hang so low, you can't believe it, but he did a great job there reversing course and finishing on the far side of the basket to avoid the block.
Allen kicks it out to Cushing. Cushing swings it over to Mosley. Mosley being guarded by Starr. Allen on the left wing. Ball gets poked out, and it will be Delaware's basketball. Mike Morsell arguing that he didn't touch it.
Mike Morsell gets out in passing lanes. He's a good gap defender, does a great job anticipating where the ball is going to be passed to. You can judge a defense's activity level by how many deflections they get, how many times they tip the ball. Even if they don't create a steal, it forces the team to take it out of bounds with the shot clock running down.
10 seconds on the shot clock. Bryant inbounds it near us, left side of the court. Mosley with the ball on the far wing. Overhand pass, Cushing deep corner three, just short off the rim. Carter goes for the rebound, can't corral it, and here comes Martin. Zach Thomas is down for Towson. It's 5-on-4 on the other end, and it's stolen away by Cushing. Thomas still down by the post. Mosley leaps over him, lays it in, and now a timeout is called, and Thomas is hunched over on his knees. He is in pain.
Now that was, fortunately for Delaware, a great job of officiating. Thomas goes down. I'm not quite sure what his injury is, but he's in almost a fetal position underneath the basket. The officials let the play go on. I think Towson should have called a timeout since they had the player down, but results in a steal by Cushing, outlets it to Anthony Mosley, who had to actually dodge and jump over Thomas as he was on the ground, and then the timeout occurs once the play stops. So that was, unfortunately for Towson, a really well-officiated play.
So they will look at Thomas, who's now seated upright on the left block of the basketball court. 56-56 here between these two rivals. 4:50 remaining in the ball game. Thomas getting looked at by Towson's medical staff. We'll take a quick break. You're listening to Blue Hens Radio on 94.7 WDSD. over Zoom, but Alex Thomas of Towson will be walked to the locker room. Seems to be okay. Walked off under his own power with an arm wrapped around the medical staff. Looked like he caught an elbow from somebody. But right now,
possibly Eric Carter on that last exchange down there. But again, I want to commend the officials for handling that perfectly. Unfortunately for Towson, it resulted in a basket by Delaware on the steal. Back in some zone here by Delaware in the 2-3.
Morcel with the fadeaway jumper, baseline good.
Boy, has Morcel been tough. He steps up. He's a senior. He's really committed to this program. An excellent mid-range shooter who's shown me a lot tonight, not only with his offense, but his tough defense on Ryan Allen at times.
Morcel with 14 points, shooting 50% from the floor for Towson. Allen dribbles with his left, slices through the defense, too hard off the backboard, rebounded by Towson. Martin pushing the envelope, wide open three, left corner good for Towson, and it was buried by Brian Starr.
Towson not known for their transition offense. They only score under 20% of the time, but a great play by Zane Martin, sharing the ball, pushing it ahead to Brian Starr, who was spotted up in that deep left corner.
It looks like it's a timeout taken by Delaware with 4 minutes even left in the ball game. Check that, it's gonna be a media timeout. We'll be back with more. Towson up 61-56 over Delaware. Blue Hens looking to try and rally here to avoid their fifth straight setback. You're listening to Blue Hens Basketball on 94.7 WDSD.
Bigger doesn't mean stronger. Don't be defined by a weight class. Introducing the all-new Terrain, the compact SUV from GMC. Mighty like a pro, the all-new Terrain.
Current lessees switch to GMC and get this low-mileage lease on this all-new 2018 Terrain SLE for around $249 per month with $999 due at signing.
We're home.
Let's go.
What kind of SUV is that? It's a brand new Buick Enclave.
That really makes it easy to unload all those little maniacs.
Sure does.
Hey, honey, we should get one of those and have like a ton more kids.
Yeah, I love that. More kids.
Yeah.
Introducing the all-new Buick Enclave, tomorrow's SUV for today's family. Current Buick lessees get this low-mileage lease on this all-new 2018 Buick Enclave for around $399 per month.
Bob Carpenter Center. Blue Hens trail Towson 61-56. 4 minutes remain in the ball game. Blue Hens looking to try and avoid their fifth straight loss. They have the ball moving right to left on your dial with Mosley at the point guard position.
Towson playing a little bit of zone. Very unusual for them in a 1-2-2, trying to confuse Delaware out of the timeout that became a media timeout.
Bryant dribbles with his left, top of the key, swings out to Allen, who pulls up for three, too hard, and it's rebounded by Sky Johnson, goes in with the reverse lay-in. Good second chance opportunity converted by Delaware.
That zone gave Delaware problems on the perimeter, but they did not block out properly. Sky Johnson taking advantage of it.
Blue Hens down by three, inside 3.5 minutes. Martin drives and finds the bottom of the basket with his left hand, and Martin starting to take over the game for Towson.
Mosley did just about everything he could. He leveled him off, sent him to his right hand, and Martin just was able to finish over top of him with that floater in the lane. But really good defense there by Mosley.
63-58, Delaware trails, 3 minutes and ticking. Allen with the ball, he's been hot from three, missed on his last attempt, looking to get separation. Swings it out to Mosley, 7 on the shot clock for Delaware. Dribble drive, swings it around the body of the defender, finds the hoop. Nice job by Mosley.
Mosley confusing Brian Starr with a little change of pace, hesitation as he rose up. A really cagey play by the senior.
Blue Hens within a tray here, 2.5 minutes remaining in the ball game. crowd getting into it. Deep three taken by Martin. He falls short. Looked like he might have slipped. Hobbled up after the shot. Seems to be okay. Here comes Delaware.
Not only did he slip, so did Anthony Mosley, who was defending him, and that's what left Martin so wide open. I think Martin was unaccustomed to seeing himself having that much clearance.
Carter on the top of the key, gives it to Bryant in some traffic. Towson playing with some man, and it's a blocking foul called against Morcell. It is his third personal. Delaware in the bonus.
Darian Bryant, a little fortunate there as he was driving right. He extended his left arm, and I thought Morcell was in pretty good position, but a good call there for Delaware. Bryant, really tough, though, trying to drive the ball on Morcell. Morcell had been switched off on Ryan Allen, trying to change up the movement on Allen by applying that 6'5", long-armed approach to him, and he got switched on to Darian Bryant, who took advantage of it.
That free throw made, Bill, is Bryant's first point of the ballgame. 0-for-7 from the floor tonight. Looking to complete the other one. He misses. It's swatted over by Johnson, but looked like he was over the back as his long arm reached over and swatted the basketball out of bounds.
Well, I love the effort by Sky, but unfortunately in that case, Keith had better positioning inside, and you just can't come over the back with your arm flat. If you go up and can try to grab the ball, but Sky Johnson was trying to tip it out with his off arm, and that's what created the foul.
That's Johnson's fifth, so he is now disqualified from the game with those five team fouls. Back-to-back games now that Delaware has had somebody foul out, and unfortunately for Delaware and Martin Inglesby, you can't really afford that with the short amount of bench that you have. You're only really going with seven players each game.
And that's why, as a player, you've got to understand the time score situation. Hey, Sky Johnson's played extremely well tonight, logging 28 minutes, doing an admirable job inside and scoring and rebounding for Delaware, but that was a foul I know he'd like to have back. You cannot allow Towson to build this lead at the free throw line. They're very tough in the end game.
Eddie Keith at the line, just shooting 53% from the stripe, misses, and there's Cushing with the rebound off the front iron.
Well, Delaware will take their time. They need to run their stuff here, look for some staggers again for Ryan Allen or Eric Carter posting up down low.
Cushing gives the ball to Allen. Blue Hens down by two, a minute 51 and counting off the clock remaining in this ball game. It's been a tightly knit game since the opening tip. Mosley feeds it through and it's good.
What a dramatic play by Anthony Mosley. He got bumped by Brian Starr, completely off balance, going away from the basket, but found a way to rise up, maintain his body positioning and use the backboard. A terrific play.
Sixth time we have been tied here tonight. Martin dribbles, Cushing trying to block it, but got too much of Martin, and he is called for the foul.
This is a Pat Scary team that's really understanding what to do in the clutch. They're going to drive the ball now. They're not going to settle for outside shots. Martin, Morcell, Starr will be pounding the ball into the lane, trying to create foul shot situations.
So that will send Martin to the line to shoot two. He's 0-for-1 tonight from the line. 13 points total. Sinks the first one.
Delaware has the possession arrow. They have a timeout if they need to use it. Towson has regrouped here and has three timeouts remaining to use in their end game.
Towson back up by a point. The Blue Hens faithful trying to distract Martin. Next shot rattles but is true. And the Tigers back up by a deuce, a minute 23 counting off the clock.
And I like the decision here by Martin Inglesby, letting his team play through it.
Mosley's pass gets knocked away by Keith. Allen will pick it up, and it will go back over center court, right to left on the dial. Allen swings it to Cushing, deep corner three, and it's good! Delaware with the lead, a three from Jacob Cushing.
Jacob Cushing being unbelievably tough on a great find by Allen, rising up into that left-handed shot wearing that face mask.
What a shot from Cushing, just playing in his 13th game of the year. Keith with the ball down low, and he answers for Towson with 46 seconds left and a timeout called by the Tigers.
A good timeout by Pat Scary after a tough guy play by Eddie Keith driving in and using the backboard to soften up the shot. But I love the resiliency of the Hens that are on the court. Jacob Cushing, who has been struggling from the long range area, did a great job there of being shot ready and rises up into that shot. A terrific play by Delaware to stay in touch with Towson.
Both teams have been capitalizing on their offensive possessions, Bill. Delaware, 4 of their last 4 from the floor. Towson, 5 of 6. So the seesawing action going right down to the wire right now. Delaware down by a single point, 67-66. And if you're Martin Inglesby, I know you're limited with the players, and a guy like Jacob Cushing may not be in this game due to the injuries with Ryan Daly and Kevin Anderson, but you're seeing some of these Blue Hens grow up in front of your very own eyes.
Absolutely. Cushing logging 20 minutes tonight. We already mentioned that Sky Johnson played 28. So as short-staffed as we are, some of these young men are really participating and playing at a very high level. That was a tremendous clutch shot. I think that's going to do a lot for Jacob Cushing's confidence level. Now, one decision that Towson has to make here is, do they want to do a 2-for-1? With 46-7 left, they've got an opportunity for Delaware to come down and maybe have them attack and then hustle the ball down, or they want to play for the last shot, depending on the situation if Delaware gets the opportunity here. But I like Scary's timeout coming off the big score by Keith. He can set his defense. I'm looking for some full court pressure here to slow Delaware down. And we'll see Delaware make that decision and whether they want to hustle the ball up or play through the clock, get the score, and then defend Towson.
Well, we've certainly seen the offenses explode. At halftime, it was 28-23. And now each team scoring 44 and 38 points. So the offense figuring it out, and it looks like this game will go to the wire. Typical rival game between Towson and Delaware, as Mosley will get the ball. Don't forget, Delaware not only trying to snap a four-game losing streak, Bill, but also a four-game losing streak against Towson.
You're absolutely right. Morsell on Ryan Allen, a big matchup here to watch.
Carter with the ball, dribbles with his right, rotates, spins off the glass with the left-handed lay-in, gives the Blue Hens a one-point lead, 68-67.
Eric Carter, not known for his dribbling. Pat Scary's going to let the team play through this.
Martin with the ball, one of the top scorers in the conference. Good feed to Gorman, who finds the hoop. And another timeout taken by Towson. Tigers up 69-68.
Zane Martin, who we have talked about, struggling from the outside, 6-for-17, but he has now 6 assists. That was a terrific bounce pass through Delaware's interior defense to find Gorman on that right block. I love players, especially leading scorers, who when they're struggling are savvy enough to figure there are other ways I can help my team win. I can defend, I can rebound, and certainly a player of Zane Martin's capability can become a very good passer. A pretty cagey player for only a sophomore.
And you talk about Martin at the half, it wasn't looking like this might be a game for him at all. 1-for-7 from the floor, 0-for-4 from three-point range. Now his line, 15 points, 2-for-3 from the lines, but you mentioned other ways to help. 7 rebounds along with 6 assists in 35 minutes played. He's done his job, certainly.
Yes, he has. I didn't get a chance to describe that Eric Carter maneuver the last time Delaware had the ball, but he drove from the top of the key. He's not known for that, but now with the expansion of the offense where Eric Carter is playing out on the outside a little bit more, dribbles in very skillfully, then spins back and works his left hand. That was a terrific individual offensive play by Eric Carter, who usually is just a low block player.
Well, if you're just tuning in, Blue Hens trail at 69-68, and now a timeout called by Delaware. There have been 8 different lead changes in the last 6 minutes of this half. Certainly a thrilling game here between Towson and Delaware. And now Martin Inglesby, second year head coach, will try and draw something up. Bill, you've been around the game. What do you think coach is saying right here?
Well, I think they're going to run a play for Ryan Allen, but Morsell's been on him, and he's been doing a good job with his length, kind of denying the ball or at least pushing Allen out further than he would like. And then the second option would be Eric Carter. So maybe we'll have some screening action with Eric Carter for Ryan Allen and see if Allen can make a decision off of that. Now it's important here that Delaware attacks the basket, leaving themselves an opportunity not only to get an offensive rebound, but if we miss and Towson gets the rebound, then an opportunity to foul them. So you've got to think that you need to start your attack at about the 10-second mark and allow yourself 6 to 8 seconds if you do miss to not only have a chance for an offensive rebound, but then to foul in order to have at least one more chance on the offensive end.
Blue Hens shooting the rock well. As of late, they have made their last 5 consecutive field goals, and their They're looking for a big one here with 18.2 seconds remaining in the ball game. Blue Hens down 69-68 here against Towson. Pep rally band getting into it. The crowd also cheering along as the Blue Hens look to try and snap a four games losing streak to end this three-game homestand before they travel down to take on Elon later in the week. Right now, it's all eyes on Towson. After the first half score was in the mid-20s, two offenses have exploded for over 40 points.
Now, Delaware's out of timeout, so they have to inbound the ball here successfully or Towson will take over. Towson, one timeout. The arrow favors Delaware. May not be a factor here, but it's good to know because Delaware out of timeouts can ill afford to try to use one if it is tied up.
So Darian Bryant will inbound the ball across from us courtside, gives it to Mosley near midcourt. 15 seconds on the game clock. Mosley looking for some help, gives it to Allen, who has five threes tonight. Allen dribbles, loses, and he travels. He lost his balance and ran into a Tiger player and ended up traveling.
And that was Marcel on him, and that defense by Marcel has really been the key to Towson defending Allen here in the end game. Delaware will go for a steal and then immediately foul.
So Eddie Keith will inbound it baseline. Cushing will be in front of him with his arms spread apart.
Now, Keith cannot move here.
8.4 seconds, and now they will call a timeout. So the Tigers call a timeout as the cat and mouse game continues. Delaware down by a point, 69-68.
Now Towson is out of timeouts as well. Arrow favors Delaware, so both teams out. One of the questions you have to ask yourself if you're Delaware's defensive staff is who do we want to foul in this situation? Pat Scarry will counter and putting only his best free throw shooters in because this is definitely a steal and then immediately foul. Probably the best one to foul on the court at this stage of the game might be Eddie Keith. You never like to foul a senior, but he might be the choice you would make, averaging just around 53% on free throws. Now, he may keep Keith out of the game in this case, but this is an opportunity where you want your seniors to have a chance to win the game, and Keith, in fact, is in. So we've got Mart Gorman, Star, Marcel, and Keith. What you might want to do if you had another timeout, you would organize this where you leave Keith open. You double-team them and then foul Keith immediately.
So it will be Star inbounding at baseline, Walker in front of him, bounce pass to Marcel, and Delaware will foul.
And in that case, unfortunately, Delaware tried to force the ball to the wide side of the court, which gave them more room, and Marcel gets it. Marcel really tough-minded and not the free throw shooter that Delaware wanted to put at the line, but sometimes the other team just executes. What they did was run Eddie Keith out where he was in no position to be fouled.
Marcel to the line. He's shooting 75% from the line this year. Has not attempted a free throw, though, tonight. Crowd gets loud.
Now, let's not forget, he gets two shots here, a little bit easier when it's not one-on-one.
And he sinks the first one. Towson back up by a pair. Eric Carter checks back into the ball game for Delaware.
This ball needs, if we're down two, the ball could be driven by Mosley or Ryan Allen. If we're down three, obviously at this point, without any timeout, you're going to have to play for the three as quickly as you can. It'll be interesting to see how Towson plays this up three if they choose to foul on the four.
Marcel's second free throw is good. Now coming into the ball game for Towson, number 11, Dennis Tunstall, 6'8", redshirt sophomore. Jacob Cushing will inbound it for Delaware. They're going right to left on your dial. Blue Hens down by three. Just under 7 seconds remaining in the contest. They give it to Mosley, and he is fouled.
And that's the decision Pat Scarry made with that psychology degree from Tufts. He's decided to foul immediately. Now, a lot of coaches will let the clock run a little bit longer and foul a little further up the court, maybe to get another 2 or 3 seconds off the clock. Mosley did a good job there, though, of advancing the ball so quickly that they had no chance to do anything but foul him immediately.
Mosley, a 71% shooter from the free throw line, 2 for 2 tonight. And he sinks the first and pulls Delaware within two once more.
This is a terrific chess match between these two really good coaches going back and forth with these decisions you have to make. Now, this is where your pre-game practice really matters because you're out of timeouts. You can't afford to bring your team over in any situation unless someone fouls out. So these are going to have to be executed due to your practice patterns.
Mosley makes both, 71-70, Delaware trails. 5.8 left on the clock here inside the Bob Carpenter Center.
Well, they should run out, and they not, and the ball is in, I believe, not Key's hands, unfortunately. Marcel again demanding the ball, and that's what seniors want to do.
And it almost looked like Delaware might have gotten the ball cleanly at first, but with two Delaware Blue Hens fouling, it will send Marcel to the line once more. Blue Hens down 71-70. Nail biter here for Delaware fans.
And if I'm going to put myself in Pat Scarry's shoes, he's probably thinking Marcel makes two, we're going to foul on the floor again. And I think that would be the right strategy, especially on the road, Corey.
Marcel has 16 points and has the first free throw rattle in, so that's now 17. Gorham coming back in for Towson, along with Zane Martin. Eric Carter back in for Delaware. Kyrie Walker takes a seat on the bench. Towson up by two. Marcel looking to add to the Towson lead. Shot is up, and it's good. Now Martin Inglesby directing his team. He wants the majority of his squad behind the center line. And it looks like it will be Cushing inbounding it, running up and down the baseline. Gives it to Mosley. Mosley is fouled. He tries to shoot it. No shot, though. And now Mosley will go to the line.
Now with 2.7 left, here's what's got to happen. Mosley needs to make the first one. They're in the double bonus. And then he needs to miss the second one. Delaware should have a play drawn up. They should know what to do here. And what would happen is Eric Carter and Ryan Allen. Now, I would put Allen out on the perimeter and have Cushing in there so you'd have your two taller players be able to tip the ball back. That's the only thing you could do in this situation.
Mosley
makes the first.
Now has 21 points, and he needed just 15 points tonight to become the 40th player in school history to reach 900 points, so congrats to Mosley.
Now Towson should not fill here, and they are, so they should have another defender out in case this gets tipped out to Cushing, he would be wide open.
Looked like Mosley tried to miss it, and it's another foul. It looked, couldn't see if Keith had the ball last, but I'm not sure if he was the one fouled.
Well, that was an admirable try. Mosley being tough, stepping up the line, making the first. He then tried to glance his second shot off the front of the rim. I almost think you want to try to miss long, have a rebound up where your offensive rebounder can tip the ball out to one of the two players on the perimeter.
Keith just shooting above 50% from the line, makes the first, and that's a big one because now it's 74-71. All but putting this game out of reach for Delaware.
You've got to credit Towson for being very good from the free throw line here in the end game. That's what a veteran team does. But a tremendous effort on both sides, offensively and defensively, by Delaware again here this evening. This is going to be a tough loss to swallow. But again, they have challenged three of the better teams in the league throughout the entire contest.
And that will end it as the shot is no good for Delaware. A heartbreaker loss for the Blue Hens. They led again in this game for a while. However, they fall tonight by the final score of 75-71. Delaware now 11-13 on the year and 4-7 in conference play. Meanwhile, Towson improves to 16-8 overall and bump up above 500 in the CAA with a 6-5 record. The American Spirit Federal Credit Union postgame show coming up next. Bill and I will break it all down. We'll also have Coach Inglesby on with us talk about tonight's tough defeat. Again, the Blue Hens fall tonight to the Towson Tigers, 75-71. You're listening to Blue Hens Game Day on 94.7 WDSD.